Hello guys, and welcome back. This is my first garden update of 2021. Here we have rosemary right here. I love the smell of rosemary, it's awesome. And we have mints in here. Lemon balm, chocolate mint, peppermint, spearmint, pineapple mint, Kentucky Colonial spearmint, apple mint. I think I mentioned one already, I'm not sure. Right here we have papaya. It's a really great plant. I accidentally chopped off the top though, so that was unfortunate. And then in here is my greenhouse. There's a Christmas cactus. There's actually a little pineapple plant, another Christmas cactus, sedum. There's a zucchini plant. There is a lemon right there, Meyer lemon. There's a wild passion flower. It's pretty cool. I'm taking a cutting of that one. And then down here we have mint. Mint cuttings on the bonsai. Two more bonsais back there. Right here we have pothoses, succulent, another Christmas cactus. And then over on the other side, we have all my little seed starting projects. I have lots of these little seed starting projects. It's pretty cool. Looks like there's calendula, zinnia, there's some catmint, some pepino melon. There's more mint cuttings, there's some wildflowers. These are all my rose mallows. There's scarlet rose mallow and crimson eyed rose mallow. There's some tomato in there, some triple crop tomato. Produces up to two bushels of fruit. Right here we have, sour gherkin. Those two. And then that one is the electric daisy. Those four are lemongrass. And that is lily of the valley. Those are a ton of little tiny cuttings of hens and chicks. It's pretty cool. There's morning glory. My compost pile is right below it. Now we're going out of the greenhouse. Right here, we have some more seed starting projects. There's cosmos and other stuff in there. And then right here, there's prayer plant. This is like my little tropical basket of tropical plants. Right here is my strawberry garden. You can see a flower right there. And up here, you can see the whole strawberry garden. I have 25 strawberry plants in total. Haven't gotten any strawberries yet. I planted them about a month ago, I'm pretty sure. Over here, we have the peach tree. And then this is in my lower garden. This is a hummingbird vine. That's sedum, a different kind of sedum than in my greenhouse. That one's strawberry. This one is grape. Beautiful green grape. This is columbine. Both of those are columbine. That is bee balm. And then that's all black-eyed Susan. That is bellflower. So many blue lemon, it's crazy. And then in the back, I didn't really show it. Oh yeah, these are stilbe. And then back over there, oh yeah, that's rose. There's another rose on that side. And then in the back, it was something else. I can't remember that name. Some butterfly bushes. Another butterfly bush. There's some yucca. There was walking onion. Asparagus. I don't love to eat asparagus, but it looks so cool. And then right here is artichoke number one. That's marshmallow. That one is artichoke number two. This is my ginormous bed filled with potatoes. There's garlic right there. And all of that is onion. Lots and lots of onion. Over here we've got raspberry. It's a really cool looking plant. Hoping to get some raspberries this year. Right here we have hops. It's really cool. I'm hoping to get some hops from it this year. And then hops vine number two. There's different hops going up. And then the other raspberry bush. Okay, this is my vegetable garden. There are collards right there, Carolina cabbage. And then right here is red Russian kale. It's a really cool looking kale. It's supposed to turn like bright purple in the winter when it gets frosted. And there's lettuce all along there. There's still little tiny things. There's spinach. here is radish. It's a radish watermelon, as I will show you. There are not... Oh, great. The leaf. And then, they're not really radishes. They're just really tiny. Hopefully, we'll get some bulbing soon. And then, I missed it there. I forgot about that one. It's wasabi arugula. And then back there are yardlong beans. There's some sunflower poking out that I planted. And what you just saw a second ago was some hyacinth, I suppose. Then back there I have some walking stick kale. And then this right here are peas. There you can see a pea right there. It just popped out of the flower. I ate one yesterday. They're so crunchy and so good. I definitely recommend peas. You can see they're starting to get a bit bigger, not just some little tiny things. Pea plants, I would say you can't plant them later than St. Patrick's Day, I've heard. And so it's a bit unfortunate for me because I wanted to plant some more peas because I just got more pea plants. But I'll have to wait until next year, or at least in the fall. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and comment. This is the end of the day. Check out my website at theearthhacker.com. Bye for now.